it almost. It's past 2:30 in the morning. But what the heck, I thought I would try to finish up this introduction to my book, Rammat's Koran. And since I have a feeling this video is going to be deleted, but not this one, I thought that I would concentrate more on this camera here. Okay. I think it's recording. Alright, I'll continue. According to Aisha, whom Muhammad married when she was only 6, Muhammad claimed to have flown on such an animal, the head of a human, wings of a bird, tail of a peacock, in his journey by night from Mecca to Jerusalem, where he said he took Moses' advice in talking Allah down from 50 prayers a day to the current 5. Sahih Bukhari, Hadith Volume 1, Book 8, Number 345. But, to me, truth is where it's at, even if it's painful. Thus, instead of lying and coming up with a new Quran that way, I feel it's best to just edit and remove most scriptures from the Quran and only focus on those scriptures in the Quran that makes sense only if the Bible is not corrupted as Muslims believe. So, instead of lying about being squeezed to near death by an angel for not being able to read or recite, point to these Quranic scriptures which warn Muslims to make no distinction between the Quran and the Bible. That is, see Quran 4, 136, 150, 151, 152, 2, 285, and 40, 70 through 72. And believe in all the books of Allah. Yeah, they're supposed to make no distinction between the Quran and the Bible, and believe in all the books of Allah. But this time, only believe the books of Allah, Bible, that is not the Quran, that we should do as the Quran says we should do with the Torah, Old Testament, and Injil, New Testament, which is to stand firm upon and use the Injil, New Testament, to judge therein of the Quran, that is Quran 568 and 547. To judge therein of the Quran as, to stand firm upon the Injil, New Testament, to judge therein of, and judge therein of the Quran, as Quran 568 and 547 commands to do with the Torah, Old Testament, and Injil, New Testament. Remember, the Quran teaches that Allah wrote the before scriptures, which can only be the Old and New Testament. Or as I always ask Muslims, then what are the before scriptures? What are the before scriptures? The Quran says it confirms. This is the crux of Rammat's Quran, and this book is separated into 3 parts. The second part that follows what I've described inside Rammat's Quran are dialogues with Muslims on the internet to show how Rammat's Quran has been wielded against Islam in the past few months. It's the latest dialogues. If you don't discount Roberto and the Guru of Hate, I didn't change the words of the Muslims presented in the second part of this book, nor did I edit what they said. I didn't change words in Roberto and the Guru of Hate either. Just edited it. On the whole, if Muslims had spelling mistakes, or if they made sense, hey, it all remains the same. The last part of Rammat's Quran contains an interjecting of speculation with the prophecy of Jeremiah and Habakkuk in relation to Iraq and the Kurds back in 2003. The speculation led to nowhere, of course. However, since the Kurds have been activated against ISIS, there is a possibility that the rest of Jeremiah 15:51 may be fulfilled soon after all. Thus I've added the document with these chapters interspersed with speculations with the speculation to this book. For one thing, if what is taking place in Iraq is the fulfillment of those chapters, it will help prove that the Bible is definitely not corrupted like the Koran teaches and Muslims fail to believe. One more thing, if you see a plus sign followed by a name, that's YouTube's way of saying at. For instance, if you see Abdullah, February 2nd, 2015, at plus Muhammad, it means Abdullah at Muhammad at Nel Yezmar, meaning that Abdullah is responding to Nel Yezmar. Okay. Yeah. What else here? Okay, that which should remain. Parts of the Quran that should stay in the Quran. Although the following scriptures from the Quran have problems with them, say Mary is assigned to all the nations, worlds, universes, depending on the English translation being one of them, and although many say the name Allah, these seem to be the only scriptures from the entire Quran that should be that shouldn't be removed, but still actually be somewhat followed and obeyed. And the first one I'm going to add is Quran 5:15. And that goes, and here's the Arabic. Here is the Arabic. For those of you who understand it. And it says this. This is the literal words of it. It says, this is what I got from Islam Awakened. Word by word. O people of the book, surely has come to you our messenger, making clear to you much of what you used to conceal of the scripture, Bible, and overlooking much of the Bible. Surely has come to you from Allah a light and clear book. Now hath come unto you light from Allah and plain scripture. Not very clear at all, if you ask me, if Christianity in the Bible is false or corrupted. Okay, now this is a pictorial version of that same scripture, Quran 5:15. It says, all people of the scripture, now hath our messenger come unto you, expounding unto you much of what you used to hide in the scripture, and forgiving much. Shakir says, O followers of the book, indeed our messenger has come to you, making clear to you much of what you concealed of the book, and passing over much. Indeed there has come to you light and a clear book from Allah. Yusuf Ali, 1985 version, O people of the book, that's Jews and Christians, there hath come to you our messenger, revealing to you much that you used to hide in the book, and passing over much that is now unnecessary. There hath come unto you Allah as new life, and has come to you from Allah a new light and perspicuous book. Okay, the sentence that is now unnecessary has been added by Yusuf Ali. He knew that such a scripture in the Quran makes no sense if the Bible is corrupted like Muslims believe. But that quote, that is now unnecessary, is not in that scripture, making it necessary to follow the Bible, contrary to how Yusuf Ali wanted it. Yeah, it doesn't say that is now unnecessary. That's what Yusuf Ali added. Okay, now, Quran 2:101 I also added in here. Here's the Arabic. Okay, literal says, word by word, and when came to them a messenger from Allah, confirming what was with them, the Bible, through a party of those who were given the book, the Allah behind their they throw it behind their backs as if they do not know. You see here, the fault lies not with the Bible, like Muslims would have you believe, but with those who would throw the Bible over their backs as if they, quote, do not know. Now here's the fickle version of that. And when there cometh unto you a messenger from Allah, confirming that which they possess, a party of those who have received the scripture fling the scripture of Allah behind their backs as if they know not. Shakir says, and when there came to them an apostle from Allah, verifying that which they have, the party of those who were given the book through the book of Allah behind their backs as if they knew nothing. Yusuf Ali. And see, the problem, look, if the Bible's corrupted, it seems to me they should throw it over their back. But here they're being attacked for throwing it over their back. And when there came to them a messenger from Allah confirming that was with them, confirming the Bible, a party of the people, the book, that would be the Jews and Christians, threw away the book of Allah behind their backs as if they had been something they did not know. Now, Quran 568, and here's the Arabic. Let's see, do I have time to wait for this? I better stop it here. Bye. Yeah, stop it here.